He went to Paris looking for answers to questions that bothered him so. He was impressive, young and aggressive, saving the world on his own. But the warm summer breezes and French wines and cheeses put his ambition at bay. Summers and winters scattered like splinters, and 4 or 5 years slipped away. Then he went to England, played the piano, and married an actress named Kim. They had a fine life, she was a good wife, and bore him a young son named Jim. And all of the answers and all of the questions he locked in his attic one day. He liked the quiet, clean country living, and 20 more years slipped away. Well, the war took his baby, the bombs killed his lady, and left him with only one eye. His body was battered, whole world was shattered, and all he could do was just cry. And as the tears were a-falling, he was recalling answers that he'd never found. So he hopped on a freighter, skidded the ocean, and left England without a sound. Now he lives in the islands and fishes the pilings and drinks his green label each day. He's writing his memoirs and losing his hearing, but he don't care what most people say. Through 86 years of perpetual motion, if he likes you, he'll smile and he'll say, Jimmy, some of it's magic, some of it's tragic, but I had a good life all the way. And he went to Paris looking for answers to questions that bothered him so.